And you use the phrase rule of law. From the very moment Trump took office, he was violating the Emoluments Clause. Very clear evidence that he attempted to obstruct justice during the Mueller investigation, inciting violence and racism, using taxes to punish people he considered political opponents, Jeff Bezos in particular, Amazon. Yes, it's all there. But what has been disturbing for me is the shredding of the rule of law, the inability on the part of the ruling elites on both sides of the aisle to stand up for the rule of law until now. And that gets to the much deeper issue that there are essentially, we live in a two-tiered legal system where poverty has been criminalized. We live in a city where Eric Garner was strangled to death by New York City police for allegedly selling loose cigarettes, which he wasn't on the day he was killed. He was, in fact, not doing anything. And then Wall Street, which has essentially rewritten the rules to. And so my worry about impeachment, which I'm not against impeachment, is that people see it as a panacea. I think many in the Democratic Party, in particular in the liberal class, have personalized our problems in the figure of Donald Trump. And in fact, the malaise runs much deeper. This is what I spent the last 2 years doing in my book, America, the Farewell Tour. It is the rupturing of what the sociologist Emile Durkheim calls these social bonds. That's where you get the term anomie. The disenfranchisement of well over half the country, the inability of them to actualize themselves, and acting out in self-destructive pathologies, whether that's hate groups, the opioid crisis, gambling, sexual sadism, et cetera. And so go ahead with impeachment, but if we don't begin to address the underlying malaise and disenfranchisement and rage and legitimate rage on the part of the white working class, however much Trump lies, and of course he lies like he breathes, the Clintons also lied in far more damaging ways to the working class and in particular the white working class than Donald Trump. And we know from polls that right before the election in 2016, you had 55% of those who said they were voting for Trump. What it was because they disliked Hillary Clinton. Only 44%. So Trump was kind of weaponized. You know, he was the middle finger to the establishment. He was weaponized against the man. If we don't begin to deal with those issues, impeachment itself will rent the fabric of American society further into antagonistic tribes, and we have to acknowledge the fact we are a country awash in weapons, 300 million weapons, mass shootings on the average of one a day. And we almost saw with Cesar Sayoc the complete decapitation of the Democratic Party with pipe bombs. That's the territory we're headed towards.